Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan selamat petang kepada semua Starian Staroba yang mengikuti live Facebook dan YouTube kita pada hari ini. Saya diberi tugas pada hari ini untuk menjadi host When the Stars Talk series episod yang kelima. Kali ini topik kita, topik yang tengah hangat sekarang, iaitu tentang kemenangan kejuaraan Liverpool sebagai champion of England untuk musim 2019-2020. Jadi bersama kita kita ada tiga orang panel di kalangan Staroba dari generasi yang berbeza. Sesungguhnya kita nak tahu apa pendapat diorang selama 30 tahun menunggu kejuaraan Premier League yang pertama. Dan bersama kita hari ini, tak lain tak bukan, Yang Berhormat Datuk Syarul Zaman Yahya, Esko Kerajaan Negeri Perak, diehard fan Liverpool ni. Kita persilakan Datuk. Assalamualaikum Datuk. Datuk boleh dengar saya? Assalamualaikum Datuk. Ada tu mungkin still lagi struggle dengan audio di sana. Atau okey. Kemudian saya gunakan panel kita yang kedua. Bro Azam Herman dari Kota Dash 86. Assalamualaikum bro.
Waalaikumsalam.
Kita tunggu Datuk Syarul ni. Dia dengar tidak kita tak tahu ni kan. Maklumlah kita live. Jadi mungkin ada sedikit gangguan teknikal audio di sana. Dan kita ada yang paling junior dalam panel kita hari ini, Liverpool Dash 2003, kita persilakan Dini. Assalamualaikum Dini.
Waalaikumsalam. Dini, apa khabar?
Baik, alhamdulillah. Alright. Saya kena nak panggil selamat datang champion semua ke channel Facebook dan YouTube Staroba. Kita tahu ramai ramai di luar sana menanti-nanti, ada yang menanti nak bash, ada yang nanti nak ucap tahniah, tapi saya rasa sebagai peminat Liverpool kita harus berbangga dengan pencapaian Liverpool untuk season ni. So saya masih lagi menunggu Dato' Charon. Dato' Charon dengar tak? Masih belum apa lagi. Dia belum. Okey, kita ke Bro Azam.
Ya, saya.
Ceritakan bila mula start support Liverpool dan kenapa support Liverpool?
Wah, ini cerita pasal saya ni pun kena muda-muda je kan. Dah lepas dah ni. Saya sebenarnya mula menyokong Liverpool ni sejak rasa saya mungkin umur 10 tahun. Jadi maknanya dah 40 tahun. 40 tahun dah saya menyokong Liverpool. Jadi 40 tahun, 10 tahun merasa kegemilangan Liverpool di apa tu era 80-an dan sampai ke tahun 90, dan kemudian 30 tahun merasa kesengsaraan lah. Jadi 10 tahun gembira, tapi masa tu kita tidak ada kemudahan dan apa tu kecanggihan teknologi sekarang ni. Jadi berita sampai kat sampai 2 minggu. Result tu kita tahu 2 minggu lepas result, lepas perlawanan. Jadi bawa betul-betul delay lah, macam Datuk Syarul tengah delay dengar kita cakap ni. Dia delay gitulah kiranya.
I can hear you guys. I cannot hear the host.
Dini, bila start dan kenapa?
Okay, saya pun back to like 1994, 1995 lah, umur 7-8 tahun. My dad, ayah saya juga old boy, Asri Mahyudin. Dia belikan apa ni, tapi dia penyokong Arsenal lah, itulah sikit kan. Dia belikan magazine apa ni, match ke shoot or something like that lah. Time tu memang banyak lah gambar-gambar Fowler, Owen, Beckham and all lah semua ni. I don't know lah, memang tak tak boleh tengok menu tu pun, time kecil-kecil pun dah rasa macam alih lah. So starting from the magazines and then tengok apa live games and all, memang time tu lah dah start suka Liverpool. Time tu memang Fowler lah kot, dia punya, I punya idol at that time. Pergi main petang-petang pun apa ni, lekat plaster kat hidung lah, Fowler kan.
So apa buat Dato' Charul, dah boleh dengar saya belum? Belum, ada masih ada audio tadi ke? Cuba tanya dia soalan sikit. Okay, tak apa, kita teruskan. Sementara kita tunggu Dato' Charul dengan dia punya audio connection. So perasaan. Maybe lepas ni boleh terus sambungkan ke Dato', suruh minta Dato' komen. Dia tak dengar saya cakap tu. Perasaan setelah 30 tahun menunggu kejuaraan Liga Perdana Inggeris, apa perasaannya? Guru Azam.
Sebenarnya saya agak terkejut juga. Perasaan tu tak ada macam orang kata adrenaline rush, apa tu, euforia dan sebagainya. Saya lebih merasakan macam satu beban dah, apa tu, dah lega, lebih kepada lega daripada perkara lain, pasal saya dah terlalu desperate kan tujuan liga tu. Liverpool bukannya tidak berjaya selama ni, selama 30 tahun sebenarnya banyak juga piala-piala lain yang telah dimenangi kan. Jadi nak mengatakan tidak ada langsung kejayaan atau sesuatu yang menggembirakan, tak logik jugalah. Kita ada Istanbul, kita ada FA Cup, kita ada banyak lagi lah cup lain, dan juga perlawanan-perlawanan yang orang kata yang kita tak boleh lupa lah kan. Tapi liga ni sesuatu yang saya rasa yang saya desperate nak. Jadi bila saya rasa satu sebab yang mungkin dia punya euforia atau kurang tu, pasal kita dalam keadaan COVID ni, PKP ni apa semua ni kan. Jadi perasaan tu lah dah lain, lain yang lebih serius yang dia rasa kan. Jadi lepas tu menang tanpa menendang bola lah tu kan. Jadi jadi dia kegembiraan tu ni lah. Kalaulah hari tu masa Crystal Palace kita menang, saya rasa tu lain macam sikit lah kot. Ataupun masa kat Everton.
Kalau kita kat Everton, kita menang masa kat Everton
kan. Kan? Jadi itulah. Itulah masa saya sebenarnya.
Dini macam mana? Dini?
Okay. Happy tu. Memang tak nak describe lah. Memang happy gila lah kan. 30 tahun tu apa ni. Yalah. We won it. We won apa ni, Champions League last season. Tapi orang apa ni, yang hater ni cakap alah Champions League EPL tak menang-menang kan. But this year I think during December pun dah nampak lah this team is going to win it lah kan. Cuma as a fan, as a football fan, still kena apa, hati-hati lah, because anything can happen in football. Tapi with the way Klopp and his boys playing, memang itulah. So dia tak ada rasa terkejut sangat sebab daripada mid season dah feel it. Cuma yalah, macam Bro Azam cakap tadi pun, due to the COVID and all apa ni, lain sikit dia punya ni, tapi euphoria tu tak datang, tapi still happy lah, still happy. Saya punya happy tak habis lagi kat social media ni, coretan-coretan.
Sama lah kita.
So, I mean, it still feels surreal, but yelah, dah lebih sekarang memang so happy lah.
Dato', macam mana Dato'?
Guys, let me say something. I cannot hear our host, but I guess I can just something. Can you guys hear me? Can you guys hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. I guess some of the question just now is when do we start supporting the team? For myself, 78 masa tu I went for tuition dekat rumah Cikgu Azharuddin in Teluk Intan. That's my parents' housing area. And he is crazy into EPL. At that time, it's not even called EPL lah. I think it's called Premier League at that time. And just like our friend just now, he subscribed to Shoot punya magazine. So, and then dia punya bilik penuh dengan all the teams lah. But his team at that point of time was QPR. So he was trying to convince me untuk sokong QPR lah. But somehow I got attracted to Liverpool. That was during Kevin Keegan, Dalglish punya time apa semua. And then bila pergi dekat Star pun continue to support Liverpool. I still remember tengok dekat Black House all the FA Cup final masa tu. Our rival was very much Everton lah at that time. And not Everton, sorry, Spurs. Lineker, Gary Lineker last time. So yeah, so I continue to support Liverpool. And of course it was a long wait, but it was a worth wait. I think one of the question probably tak tanya lagi kot, my favorite player, of course lah, I mean people won't call me Syarul Gerard for nothing. Perasan sikit. Of course we didn't win the league couple of years back also.
Syarul Gerard, yeah?
That famous stumble. But syukur Alhamdulillah we finally won it. Like Dini mentioned just now, it was kind of an anti-climax because we know that we're going to win it. It's just a matter of which game. But I was really hoping that Chelsea didn't win or draw that game against Man City, because I thought we want to win the championship by beating City this Friday. But it's okay. Again, it's just a matter of time. So akhirnya Alhamdulillah lah, we won the league. And I am not sure about the record, but 2009, me and my family went to Anfield for the first time, and we went berserk at the club store. Semua nak beli macam-macam, and then masa nak bayar tu, it was a game day against Wigan, and the queue was very long at the cashier. So masa nak bayar tu, when the cashier actually told me how much is the bill, I was like, hey, cannot be true. So I look at my kids, four of my boss who also supported Liverpool, and my wife, and say kena kurangkan sikit barang-barang ni sebab mahal sangat. Banyak sangat kan, tinggi sangat the bill. Tapi orang ramai kat belakang, so I cakap okay lah, just bayar je lah. So because of that, the club store manager came out and shake my hand and said that it's the biggest transaction of the club store ever. And we were given executive lounge apa semua because of the transaction. I'm not sure whether that transaction is still the highest, but I end up probably paying it through my credit card for the next couple of years lah. But anyway, it was a worth visit to Anfield, and again Alhamdulillah finally we won it.
Okay, terima kasih Datuk. Walaupun Datuk tak dengar ni, kena fit antara satu sama lain lah. Sorry, kita punya live ni is live. Yes.
Kali yes, nak feedback sikit, apa ni, nak komen sikit. Datuk cakap pasal Gerard tadi.
Okay, alright.
Datuk Syarul Gerard tu betul. Sebab saya pernah main time over weekend dengan dia. Dia masuk lambat, boleh score, boleh assist, relax je. Memang Gerard.
Memang Gerard. Itu junior bagi Chan. Kalau tak,
okay. Okay, the main person dalam Liverpool ni, kita boleh kata semua pihak daripada players, managers, owner, even yang buat apa, dia orang punya breakfast every day, semua mainkan peranan penting. Tapi the key person dekat Liverpool is, saya rasa semua setuju, is Jurgen Klopp. So kenapa Jurgen Klopp? Apa menyebab? Bro Azam, kenapa Jurgen Klopp ni very special? Walaupun dia cakap diri dia, I'm the normal one, kan? Tapi kita tahu Jurgen Klopp ni is someone yang memang special.
Okay. Sebenarnya saya dah ikut Klopp ni dari zaman dia di Dortmund dulu lagi. Jadi he is one hell of a guy lah. Dan rasanya semua orang tahu dia, karakter dia very outspoken, very apa tu, man management dia memang tip top, apa tu, peluk player and all that stuff lah kan. But I want to stress about one thing dan yang saya nampak yang mungkin orang tak perasan adalah his adaptability on the team, the tactics and the management. Kalau kita tengok ya, dia masa dia Dortmund, dia sebenarnya he's a very staunch 4-2-3-1. He's one focal point and striker lah. Aubameyang and then Lewandowski and all that stuff lah. And then masa tu dia punya fullbacks dia memang tak cross the middle line pun, half line, halfway line pun. But bila dia datang ke Liverpool, of course masa mula-mula dia datang tu dia try to bring his philosophy and bring his template lah kan. But bila dia datang and then dia tengok the players available, even masa dia datang dia tak ada beli player pun masa mula-mula first season, first year tu kan. But he work with what he got. And his eye for talent, his eye for players' ability tu memang kita tak boleh nak challenge lah. Orang cakap pasal gegen pressing, his gegen pressing. Masa dia Dortmund memang he gegen press a lot. Tapi sebenarnya bila dia datang Liverpool, bila he found out that there's no actually suitable striker to play his Lewandowski punya role, dia tukar ke 4-3-3. Bila dia tukar ke 4-3-3, he played a very fluid 4-3 and he changed the whole system. And then bila dia dah dapat good apa tu success pun, dia tak stop kat situ. He changed to a different 4-3-3 bila dia ada dua fullbacks, very 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 excellent attacking fullbacks. So dia tukar lagi. And then kita boleh tengok juga the influence of assistant manager dia. Dulu masa dia datang Buvac, orang duk sibuk kata Buvac is actually the brain behind the tactics. And then dia ni just motivator. But bila Buvac keluar, dia tukar dia punya system and he succeeded. So this one thing that people underestimate is actually his adaptability lah. That's my view about him. Yang saya rasa lagi penting untuk dia sustain the success for the club.
Datuk, ada komen?
Bro, kalau klub nak retire lepas ni, kau jadi coach Liverpool. Gila batas.
Saya cakap kosong ni tu. Cakap macam mana boleh kan.
Dahsyat betul dia punya kupasan tu. Gila babi. For me, klub ni, people can talk about all the technicalities and whatnot about him. But to me, that's just one very important punya point lah about this guy that I see. And it's about going back to the basic fundamental, bro. He is so humble, you know. You look at the relationship that he built dengan the players, not many people can do that. And at the end of the day, to me, it's all about relationship. I mean, you can be the best technical coach in the world, but if you cannot build your relationship with the players, if you cannot connect, if you cannot communicate, it's not going to happen. It's all about relationship. And he managed to do that. I'm not saying the other coaches before this didn't do that. They did, but he did it in a very special way lah. Susah. I rasa tak ada orang lain boleh buat benda macam tu. The way he connect, the way he touch, the way he link with the players is incredible. And I think that is, apa ni, besides all the technicalities ni, I think that's the key thing to our championship this year. Humbleness, you know. That's why he came and then he said he's not the special one, but he's a normal one, you know. So humble. And I'm telling you guys, I'm sharing with you guys, I'm telling myself, humbleness will take us a long way, guys. InsyaAllah.
Ya. Okay, betul, Datuk. Saya sangat setuju. Abang Azam, Bro Azam punya komen memang superb lah kan. Kita tak boleh nafikan. Yes, betul. Dini, for this season,
okay,
bagi 3 main player yang bawa Liverpool ke kejuaraan liga ni dan kenapa?
Okay.
Saya nak 3 je.
3 eh? Actually, it's very hard to choose 3 lah. I mean, everyone is apa ni is very important to the team. Even the subs pun kan, Lalana pun sama lah. Kalau dia tak gol lawan Man U tu, dah kalah kan? Okay, but if I have to choose 3, I think it would be Mane, Van Dijk, and I would say Trent. Okay, Mane. Okay, the first season Salah masuk, Salah memang he was the man lah. Again, Mane was a bit overshadowed. Last season was a bit lebih kepada Firmino. I don't know lah. That's my own opinion lah. Firmino and Salah a bit. Mane ada juga, but dia ada injured and then dia ada kena kad merah dengan Man City, beberapa game ban and all. But this season Mane, I tengok different level. Even if you guys pernah dengar ada quote by Messi sendiri pilih Mane as his choice for Ballon d'Or punya winner. Okay, and then Van Dijk, tak cakap apalah kan. Liverpool punya defensive record this season berapa banyak dah clean sheet kan. I mean, the whole defensive unit is very good lah, but the leader is Van Dijk lah, tak cakap. We all know that. Okay, for Trent ni, I see him as someone that will be in the future Liverpool punya captain lah. He will take it from Hendo lah, tak lama lagi rasa. I mean, he is developing to be one of the best right backs in the world. Arguably now maybe one or first, second, third in the world lah. Umur baru 22 kan, but the stats is very amazing. You assist in EPL, I think he's second belakang Kevin De Bruyne. Kevin De Bruyne memang lah dia main as a attacking midfielder or apa midfield for City kan, memang tugas dia assist. But this boy is playing right back and going up and down and then playing defensive also, tapi boleh assist banyak tu and all the free kicks and all. I think that 3 orang tu lah for me. Yeah.
Okay, Dato.
Bro, I will refuse to answer that question because it's unfair for you to single out 3 players or even 2 or even 1 player. You know, don't do that, man. I mean, we are here because everybody did their part.
Their part.
So
yeah.
If you ask me that question, I'm gonna refuse answering you because it's unfair to single out any players for that matter. You know, everyone.
Understandable.
The subs, the second team, all the backroom staff. And I mean, you know, it's just like. Any other team lah, it's just like rugby pun. I mean, it has to be, this is a team thing, you know. So, I think it's unfair to single out 3 players or 2 or 1 or even 11 players for that matter pun tak boleh. Macam Dini cakap tadi, you know, Lalana masuk and you know, jadi super sub. That couple of second tu really make a difference. So, I think we must talk about the whole team, how they stick together. Win is very normal to hear all this squabbling between the players in the squad and things like that. But we never hear that in Liverpool. You know, they really stick together. And again, I think that's because of the leadership of the coach lah, or the manager.
Okay, Bro Azam, ada komen?
Saya nak go against the grain. I want to single out one player, maybe controversial. I would like to say thank you very much to Adrian. Dia actually memanglah dia screwed up in the defeat to UCL, defeat to Atletico itu. But masa Alisson injured, seven games in the league, he still managed to help Liverpool win games. So he might not be as good as Alisson. Memang ada blunder apa semua, but I think he's better than Minole. So a very able deputy. Kalau dia screw up, maknanya masa time Alisson injured, lepas tu dia buat blunders and then leaking goals apa semua, we are not going to have this conversation right now lah. So mungkin orang tak, mungkin ada yang tak senang. But thank you to Adrian juga. So that's my maybe against the grain punya apa tu pandangan.
Okay, thanks. Tu kita ada komen daripada Zain Zaha tu. Dia kata when the Reds goes marching in 3-4, dia suruh kita dia suruh kita chanting pula ni kan. Okay, untuk next question, siapa, kita dengar banyak rumours, kita dengar daripada Timo Werner, kita dengar macam-macam Jordan Sancho lah, the few players di luar sana yang yang di gempar-gemburkan nak join Liverpool for the next season. Tapi sebenarnya siapa yang sepatutnya kita beli untuk next season? Dapat kita mulakan Abang Azam.
Sebenarnya saya frust Timo Werner tu pergi Chelsea. I think Timo Werner is going to be perfect for Liverpool. Dia punya style dia, dia punya apa tu, age, and then the potential of him getting better, the way he plays, his mobility, his hunger, so he's perfect for Liverpool. Kalau ini sebenarnya saya punya personal experience lah. I follow player dulu masa Suarez main kat Ajax, saya cakap ini kalau Liverpool beli ni memang he's going to be hit. So Suarez memang hebat. And then I talked about Firmino masa di Hoffenheim. Cakap apa tu, kenapa masa tu Brazil punya World Cup 2014, kenapa tak ambil dia? He's going to be a unique player. So he came to Liverpool and he succeed. So maybe saya nak kena hantar jadi scout to some of the leagues teams lah kot. But I think it was a big mistake for Liverpool not buying Timo Werner. Player lain maybe Kai Havertz is okay. He's somebody yang very high ceiling, but he's very expensive. So I don't think Liverpool want to buy that kind of players lah. Selain daripada tu, kalau macam all the cheap ones, mana tadi saya discuss bila tengok Top Canwell main Norwich masa dia score goal against Man U, he was excellent last night. So maybe we need to produce more Andrew Robertson rather than buying Kai Havertz, Jadon Sancho and all that stuff. Kita tak, I don't believe in that lah. So that's my view of it.
Okay, Dato' Syarul ada komen pasal ni, pasal pembelian player? Cuba fit dia sikit. Dia tak dengar suara dia. Dini?
Okay, I never think too much lah pasal players yang dipatut dibawa masuk ni. Usually tunggu je lah sampai habis transfer window, nanti kita apa ni, berserah je lah. Tapi betul, I setuju juga yang Werner punya case tu. I mean, stress juga lah dia pergi Chelsea kan. I mean, dia memang dah express dia punya desire lah nak main for Liverpool, but I don't know lah what happened with the owners and all. I think the tempat yang perlu strengthen or ada backup, it should be one more attacker, because next year dengar macam AFCON jalan kan, so bye-bye lah Sanah dengan Mane kan. So kita tinggal with whom? Firmino, Minamino dengan apa, maybe Ox lah kot, Origi. So macam tak berapa strong lah. Maybe if we get one attacker yang ada mole Salah dengan Mane tu, macam cantik juga. And then I think I would like one left back lah untuk cover Robo. Milner okay, tapi Milner pun getting not getting any younger walaupun still fit. Umur sama dengan aku tapi beza, jauh beza. Umur sama-sama ni. Aku nampak muda lah nak cakap sebenarnya. But okay. I mean, cover for Robo will be good lah. I mean, on the right, trend dah ada Nico Williams tu. Nico Williams tu, I tengok future star juga tu lah. Yeah, an attacker and a left back lah for me. Left back, I mean tak payah pergi jauh lah. Kau tengok England, maybe you can get Chilwell but probably mahal lah kan sebab English player macam overrated sikit kan. Maybe can, kalau Klopp ni tak risau sangat lah, he will find a robo and then dia boleh develop those guys lah. Attacking Sancho tu macam menarik tapi ya dengan price apa sekarang ni kan, maybe will be a bit hard. But apa lah, I just believe Klopp and his apa ni, his staff ada dia punya scout semua dah ada player in mind lah, because we want to win, we have win this season. Kita nak try to dominate for berapa belas tahun lagi lah kalau boleh kan. I mean, if you look at Man City punya bench dengan Liverpool, memang beza lah walaupun kita menang season ni. But who knows lah, next season maybe City will get stronger and kalau kita macam ni juga takut tak boleh nak sustain lah. Itu je lah. I never think too much lah about the transfer. Nanti keluar Mbappe lah apa semua kan, tapi harapan je lah kan. Itulah.
Datuk, recommend?
Guys, I'm more conservative. I feel that why we are here and why we are such a great club is because of the internal grassroots development that Liverpool is doing, the academy and all the backup teams. And while there have been some very important signing in the past and for this championship team, but I think they need to continue to look at what we have internally from the system, from the club system. So because if they don't do that, then there's a danger that nobody would want to go into the system because they will feel that at the end of the day Liverpool signed somebody from outside. So while perhaps they want to look at one or two players from outside and to bring them in, I think it's extremely important to look at what we have internally, because if we look at the history, so many impactful players ni are players that dikeluarkan daripada kilang Liverpool sendiri lah, our own mill. Therefore, I think it's very important to continue to do that.
Okay, thank you. Okay, yang menang Liga Jumaat lepas. So orang ada fan club lain ni dia mocking dengan kata, masa COVID nak celebrate macam mana. So kita as a fan yang menunggu 30 tahun ni, tak ada. Bila kita menang, it's no celebration. Puas tak sebagai fan Liverpool, kita rasa puas tak? Abdul Azam.
Celebration tu relative actually. Depends on how you describe and how you anticipate what is the celebration lah. Dan jadi kepuasan tu datang dari dalam. Tak semestinya kita turun ke jalan, pasang flare dan sebagainya lah kan. But memang kurang shock sikit lah. It's supposed to be a very grand occasion. Dan saya rasa kita kat Malaysia ni pun walaupun rasanya kalau tak ada COVID ni, tak ada PKPP ni semuanya, rasanya hari Jumaat, hari tu, Sabtu semalam pun dah banyak dah kot. Puan Presiden kita pun terus dipanggil ke DVD ke Astro kan untuk ni interview. Jadi the celebration is expected, tapi orang kata bila norma baru ni kita celebrate cara norma baru lah. Yang mana boleh kita celebrate, yang mana tak boleh kita delay dulu. Macam Klopp pun ada kata, dia kata the parade, the celebration will come even though it's 12 matches in the next season, the trophy is still ours, and we have the right to celebrate. So the club will decide, and kita ada setahun untuk celebrate, and hopefully tahun depan kita sambung celebration lagi. So mungkin besok nanti kata bila apa tu open bus, open top bus parade tu pegang sampai dua sekali piala kan. 2021 pun piala kita punya juga. So we are celebrating, we will celebrate. So that's my about the view of it lah.
Datuk? Datuk ada komen?
Guys, to me, not being able to celebrate in a normal way is a very a good thing, because in it itself it shows the character of the club Liverpool. I think we celebrate every week. We celebrate when we win. We celebrate when we lose. We celebrate when we become champion. We celebrate every time we play. It's a celebration. Even when we lose, we will celebrate because we know that the players, the team has given the best. So yeah, some of our haters make such a big deal that we are not able to celebrate this thing. But I told them that, you know, we don't have to celebrate the normal way, because we are different. You know, we, as I said, we celebrate week in, week out with every performance that the team showed. So not a big deal. I think this session is a celebration. The communication that's been going on, all the coverage on the social media, all those videos that people has produced, you know, to celebrate this championship. I think, you know, it's a very unique way of celebrating all this. I mean, like Azam cakap lah, tak payah nak go down to the street and pasang flare and what all those normal things. You know, it's very special. I think. We celebrate by reflecting what we have gone through. Korang muda lagi, guys. You guys are still very young.
Eh, saya dekat sama saya tu. Ha? Saya dekat sama saya tu. Datuk form 5, saya form 3 tu.
Oh, okay. But what I'm trying to say is, you know, this 30 years yang orang cakap ni, some of the youngsters, they don't feel like my kids, you know, when we talk about this 30 years, they, yeah, okay, they know it's 30 years, but they don't actually feel it. But kita ni, I mean, see, we've been there this whole 30 years. We were there, bro. We were there supporting, we were there waiting, we were there, you know, berapa kali Frans menongging dan sebagainya. But we are still here. So that in itself to me is celebration yang tak, orang lain tak boleh buat lah, you know. It's something very, very special.
Okay, alright. Betul lah. Even di UK pun dia orang langgar je dia punya MCO kan untuk celebrate kat stadium kan, tak boleh tahan je. Tapi kita di Malaysia ni rasanya sekarang ni so far saya pun tak dapat apa-apa makluman lagi tentang ada celebration yang tidak daripada mana-mana pihak lain lah. But tak apa, kita celebrate dalam hati ataupun sendiri-sendiri je, tak ada masalah. Okay, the next question. Persembahan Liverpool musim ni memang out of the world lah. Okay, kita cuma sekarang ni kita still seri dua perlawanan dan kalah satu perlawanan. So kita nak tanya panel apa pendapat korang pasal tentang tim lain? Kenapa Liverpool boleh menang begitu cepat dan kenapa tim lain ni terlampau struggle untuk mengejar Liverpool? Kita mulakan dengan gini.
Bukan cakap pasal Liverpool, cakap pasal tim lain.
Tim lain ni. Kenapa tim lain ni terlampau susah nak kejar Liverpool season ni?
Susah nak jawab kan? Apa ni? Okay lah, I mean, okay lah. Kalau kita tengok from last season, City dengan Liverpool memang neck to neck lah kan. Beza just one point. This season kita expect memang Man City lah the title challenger. Dan a few other clubs lah yang kita tengok at the apa time summer beli player-player yang bagus and apa pre-season and all macam Spurs, Chelsea, Arsenal dan nama yang tak perlu cakap tu lah, lagi team tu. Tapi I mean joke aside, I tak nak cakap that Liverpool menang purely because team lain tak perform. No, you cannot take anything away from Liverpool performance this season. Memang I think ya, macam Kali cakap tadi lah, memang two draw and one satu kalah je kan. So memang exceptional lah kan. Cuma maybe City tak tahu nak cakap. City pun not bad juga tapi kelakar lah, dia ada kalah dengan Chelsea at home, dia ada kalah dengan Manchester United at home and all. So maybe with a bit of help from the other teams yang tiba-tiba macam a bit rocky lah this season, City, Chelsea. But then the emerge of Leicester, Sheffield and Wolves tu looks like bagi ialah dia FPL lah kan. You never know. Itu Leicester boleh menang apa league. Blackburn pernah menang league. And then this season Leicester sekarang I think number 3 or number 4, tak tahu Chelsea dah potong ke tak. Sheffield play with a system yang memang suited for their teams and players. And then there's Wolves sekarang ni dah atas Man U lah kan. So I mean that's football lah, that's EPL. That's why EPL is the best in the world lah, hands down. Diorang boleh cakap lah yang geng-geng Serie A ke geng-geng apa ni Barcelona, Real Madrid cakap diorang boleh. I think for the past 3-4 years memang apa ni EPL team dominated apa ni ada scene lah. So itu je lah kot nak komen banyak pun tak ni lah, takut kena apa ni, kena kecam lah nanti. Banyak saja cakap tapi apalah, kita bagi you Datuk kecam tak apa kan.
Datuk kecam tak apa. Datuk ada komen?
Bagi Azam cakap dulu. I haven't managed to catch what's the question.
Okay, Bro Azam.
Bukan kecam lah, tapi all other teams needs to face the fact that they are not at the same level as Liverpool right now. Kenapa? Saya rasa salah satu sebabnya they are in their rebuilding process themselves. Yeah, kalau kita tengok Chelsea dengan the young teams, and then kalau kita tengok even Arsenal pun ada problem dengan managers. Arsenal sekarang ni dia lebih kurang macam kita dululah, masa ni masih mencari-cari manager yang sesuai. Jadi bila manager tu tukar cepat apa semua, player pun susah nak filosofi of different players. Lepas tu tak berani cakap pasal Manchester United. Nah, saya berani cakap pasal Manchester United. Ramai yang bertanya pun sebenarnya. Manchester United now is like Liverpool in 1995. Masa tu we have some excellent players. Ada Robbie Fowler, kita ada masa tu all the Spice Boys masa tu, Matt Manaman, David James. Dan sebenarnya kalau tengok talent, they should be challenging for title year in year out. But masa tu yalah, sampaikan kena kutuk fan Liverpool ni, next year will be our year. And I've written quite a long article about it. Lepas ni tengok ada dalam Facebook saya. Kita masa tu 95, 96, 97, 28 tahun tak menang league, kita rasa benda tu blip. And then it suddenly become 10, become 15, 20. And don't be surprised that Manchester United will go down that route if they are not careful lah. So I'm not saying that they will go down boleh tak tahun, because they are too weak not to hit a jackpot somewhere along the line. But sekarang ni saya rasa they are quite way behind lah. In fact, to make things worse, manager pun quite questionable. And from footballing point of view, I feel for them. But as apa tu, a rival, tu sekarang lagi lah, simpan lah oleh tu lagi 2-3 musim tu. apa tu view about it lah. Itu saja.
Datuk.
Okay, guys, you know what has happened to our team ni, and this championship is a reflection of the history, tradition, and also the processes that we have gone through, which is why make us what we are today. I'm not saying the other team ni lopek tak, they're also good, you know, they spend a lot of money, they spend more money than us and things like that, but they're not necessarily had the opportunity to go through the processes that we have gone through. I mean, if you look at the history, Liverpool, we really went through the process and all kind of things. I mean, the tragedy, and masa aku jatuh tu, akulah jerat jatuh, you know. So we have gone through it all. We have gone through it all. And what we had this year, again, is to me a manifestation of what Liverpool has been through throughout these years. Daripada dulu lagi, daripada 70s, 80s, 90s, we have gone through all this process, and that is why we are what we are today. Because we have experienced it all. Kita dah rasa macam-macam. And that makes us stronger, that makes us more
believer,
agile,
become a believer,
and then having somebody like Klopp to come with such a very basic fundamental punya approach of being humble, emphasizing on relationship that I mentioned just now. So all that make us what we are today. So the others are good, but perhaps they haven't gone through the processes that we have gone through. And you look at us, the camaraderie that we have. Again, kalau cakap ni yang geng-geng lain ni menyampah lah dengar kan. I mean, the camaraderie that we have within the Liverpool punya family, the fans apa semua ni, is different, bro. Different than the other club, you know. Because we stick together throughout the years, for better, for worse, mostly for the worse. How many times we are so close but not there, but alhamdulillah. So akhirnya all those sacrifice, you know, some of us could have easily just switch and sokong some of the team yang selalu menang in this decade, but we stick to our team. And alhamdulillah, at the end of the day, everything that happens ada hikmah. You know, it's written already, and this is our year. Finally, we can say that.
This is our year, yeah? Okay, thank you, Dato. Okay, kita ada dua question lagi. Okay, next season, mungkin terlalu awal untuk kita cakap pasal contenders, title contenders for next season. Eh, siapa yang agaknya kalau Liverpool nak mengekalkan kejuaraan, tim mana yang mungkin akan menjadi title contenders? Razam atau Datuk, boleh jawab dulu?
Saya rasa City dan Chelsea.
City
they are still very good. They will buy more players. Jadi mungkin sikit menurun lah, sebab dia punya player pun dah ramai, dah tua. Aguero is getting older. It's very difficult to get somebody like Aguero nak replace him. David Silva is retiring. So Fernandinho. So dia ada ramai, ada ramai player tua. Actually problem dia orang punya player tua lagi teruk sebenarnya. Tapi they are still a very good team with an excellent manager. Pep is a very good manager. Chelsea very exciting. I'm very excited to look at Chelsea pasal I think Lampard will do better than this season. Orang punya he's doing better. With the addition of this new player Timo Werner and then Kim Ziyech also is coming. So they are buying more. Dengar kata nak beli Havertz pula. So kalau Lampard can apa tu gel the together, I think they will be a force to be reckoned with.
Okay. Dini, comment tentang contenders next season.
My answer will be the same as Azam lah. I think City memang you know lah, Pep pun how he plays, and then dengan nak beli player baru lagi, and dia orang kena ban kan from EPL kan, Champions League right
kan, belum tentu lagi
if they dah kena ban tu, I mean lagilah they can just focus on domestic punya cup kan, and then as sama juga macam Cik Azam cakap tadi, Chelsea I think exciting lah with the players yang dia dah beli, Ziyech dengan Werner sekarang ni pun quite okay lah, not quite good jugalah the team that Lampard have, the youngsters. I mean mungkin next season a bit early sebab the new players dah kena gel and all, but I think over the years they will be the contender lah. I would like to see Brendan Rodgers and Leicester jugalah to perform next season. They have a good strong apa ni group of players now pun, defend, midfield and attacking very stable. Complementing each other. It's just maybe if Brandon can get a few other players to kuatkan team dia. And also Wolf lah. If Wolf can retain all the players, Jimenez, Traore, any pun gonna be want to watch out jugalah. That's all.
Datuk, argument?
I don't want to talk about any other club.
Okay, tak apa. Okay, kita dah sampai ke hujung. Sebelum kita akhiri perbincangan kita petang ni, ada satu soalan. Soalan ni daripada komiti juga. Cuma soalannya sepatutnya tanya kepada saya ni. Tapi kita tak tahu. Mungkin ada apa. Soalan ni, apa perancangan fan Liverpool di kalangan Staroba ni, ada tak nak buat satu trip ke Liverpool? Ada niat atau apa? Mungkin saya boleh arrange kan lah.
Itu perlu
jawab. Dia kena tuan presiden, lepas tu boleh buat jumpa sekali apa tu owner kan. Salam owner sikit. Tapi
kena buat.
Seriously kalau ada memang saya berminat lah. Kalau dia buat memang saya akan sokong.
Setuju.
Datuk boleh pergi tu. Ada masa lah nak pergi.
Datuk LFC store dah lain dah sekarang ni. Bukannya orang dulu.
Oh ya.
Dah lain dah.
Okay. Okay, last
kita,
kali kita
kali as a president of Liverpool fan club Malaysia, Ali, can you request one thing for me?
Yes.
To the club. Bagi jerat lah yang leave the trophy.
The trophy. Tapi kalau kita tengok pada komen daripada Klopp pun, dia kata the trophy, the championship pun sebenarnya one of the orang yang patut dia celebrate is Gerrard, because Gerrard hold the apa ni tanggungjawab is too long kan. So I think Gerrard deserve. Okay, sebelum kita berpisah, kita one round dulu. Any last word daripada Datuk mungkin? Datuk dengar tak tu? Mesti tak dengar. Last word, Bro Azam.
Datuk Syarul, any last word from you?
I've given my conclusion just now, so never walk alone.
Walk alone. Terima kasih, Datuk. Bro Azam?
It's been quite an interesting discussion lah. Dan saya rasa Datuk, lepas tu Dini, and then Kali pun, I think you are you guys are very knowledgeable. I think you guys have you know what Liverpool is, the essence, and then how it feels to become a Liverpool fan. Dan saya rasa ramai di luar sana, Staroba sendiri pun memang ramai yang fanatic and knowledgeable. Dan I think I'm not that sure about other fans, but I think we can safely say that we are one of the most knowledgeable fans in the not maybe dunia tak tahu, tapi kat dalam Staroba saya rasa we are one of the most knowledgeable fans about our, but not only about our team but also about other teams in the league in football in general. I think bukan nak masuk bagul angkat sendiri, but I think kudos to all the Liverpool fans there. Terima kasih.
Okay, terima kasih kepada tiga panel kita pada hari ini, Datuk Syarul Zaman Yahya, Bro Azam Herman dan Dini Fadli, membincangkan topik penantian 30 tahun Liverpool menjuarai kejuaraan Liga Inggeris. So kita jangan lupa kepada anda yang berada di rumah yang subscribe, tolong subscribe kepada channel YouTube kita, dan juga berikan sokongan kepada When the Stars Talk series ini, dan kita akan kembali pada minggu akan datang untuk membincangkan topik-topik yang lain. Terima kasih kepada tiga-tiga panel tadi. Terima kasih Datuk, terima kasih Bro Azam, terima kasih Dini ya. Kita jumpa next kejuaraan pula kita buat live lagi untuk semua. So, saya kata Liverpool is the champion of England. Sekian dari saya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh.